What is up, everybody? My name is Mr. Energy. Welcome back once again to Subnautica. Today we are back once again at the base, or the temporary base as it is. And as you can probably tell, I am taking it apart. And the reason I'm taking it apart is because it is trying to move to our new base. And inventory is full. Okay, inventory is full, and then we will move to our new base, and reconstruct everything in there. It's really cool that they have the entire structure built for us. The only downside is everything is considered as in outside, not inside, so it can't put things in like wall lockers on the walls in there. So I will have to make a little base inside the bigger base, if that makes any sense to people. But yeah, and then I'm also gonna go over to the floating island. That is a lot of titanium. Jeez. I'm gonna go over to the floating island, and we're going to get some of the resources, because if you guys haven't noticed, it is nowhere near as pretty as I like it to be, and I like to have my flowers and my vegetables and all the types of foods I can have. I like all that. So we're going to go over there and take care of that so that they don't have to worry about anything else. Also, something I noticed when leaving is that is where it is in location. There is this huge, like, cloud thing there. And if I was any dumber, I would have never seen that. But, like, this is so obvious that they are hiding something in that cloud. So, and then there's another cloud over there, which is for the other bases. And what on earth? Oh, wait. I know what you are. You're. There's land. Why is there land up here? But no, it's one of these guys. And looky here. There's a huge cloud covering this thing, too. I thought so. Anyways, here we are. We are at the floating island, almost. It'll be right behind this fog. But this floating island should have every resource we need as far as that is concerned. And, okay, so something is bugging me right now. So as you guys can see, from my position, it looks like there is something right there. So we're gonna go right at it. And then when I get near it, though, I'm pretty sure it's hidden inside of the island, which means there might be something inside here that I haven't seen yet. Look. Now it's loading in. It looks like it's behind the main island. And now it doesn't exist. I don't get that. But it was right here, so let's see if I can find it or figure out what it was. And then we'll decide. It must be some sort of, like, base thing, and I don't know what it would be, though. I feel like it's directly underneath that, though, which is holding the outdoor plants, but you can put those on any regular land, so I don't know why they would have that issue.
Caution.
I don't know.
Mild dehydration detected.
And apparently I'm thirsty. Well, fortunately, I am in a great place to get some water, so that will be easy for me. And then we'll also be able to get a whole bunch of these different types of plants on here, because I love plantation, and this is the best place to get it. And this looks like a good spot to park. One of everything, as far as I understand, Ming plant, Jaffa cup. Yes, I think so. I don't think there's anything else I can think of. I have a Jaffa cup and a grub basket, right? Yes. And then I have a pink cap and a speckled rattler. I have Ming plant, marble melon, and voxel shrub seed. Everything on there should be what I need. I need to grow it, clearly, but that I will do at another point as soon as I get everything ready. I probably could grow them all in little pots for now, one in each pot. And then when I get back to the base, I can actually put them in there. Actually, I'll just put them in the locker for now. That'd be way easier. And then I'll decide it. Actually, what is this? Wait, can I pick this? I can't pick that. Dang it. All right. That's everything. Back to the boat we go. Ooh, what is that? Oh, that might be what I want. I might need that. Second. Yep. Yep. There it is. Okay. What is this? Can't have that. I want one of these. Please. One of those. Yep. Okay. What was it? Oh, yeah. This thing. Battery charger. Yay! I think I only need two of those, and I already have one, right? Yes, I have it. All right. Good. Salt. Salt's always nice. Until I have infinite amounts of it. I'm tempted, since I'm right here. We can fit that down there. I don't know. I'm tempted to go down there and just see what's down there before I leave. It's just a hole. But I don't think I can fit my Cyclops down there. And it'd probably be better for me to go back another time and get down there because... Whoop. Because I'm hitting things if I don't. Look out. Alright. So, last stop on my list of things to do is go to my... my bobber, which is the life pod, and see what I left there. I believe I left some sort of equipment or something there. I don't remember what it was, but I'll grab everything I can out of there, and then I will go back to our new base to go see what we have, unless I find something on the way. So I will see you guys very soon. Ooh, I have a purple artifact in here. Yes, please. I'll take that. That would be great. All right. Here we are. Home sweet home at our new base. And that was a Reaper Leviathan. Right down there. This is a dangerous area. And that's even scarier. I think those are warpers or something like that. And they like teleport you. That's all I remember about them. Anyways. So this right here is a little pathway I found on the way back home. I kind of saw it. So I waited till daylight. And here we are. Couldn't really see anyway. It looks like these are lights going up, but I don't believe they're bright enough to really help me see anyway. Because there's like a few of them, not like a whole bunch. There are crabs up here though, so that is something to note. And... Okay. What is this all about? Ow. Stupid thing attacks me. Whoa. Okay, this is interesting. Is there something else up here that I should note? What is that? Can't raise it. Well, I think that's magnetite, or however you say it. But I need to figure out how to get up there higher, which doesn't look like it's too hard. Just gotta follow the pathway up. Oh, there's spores here. Oh, had I known that, I wouldn't have taken any from the other place. Ooh, artifacts. That's always good. Okay, so now I have two extra artifacts. Anything else I need? I wonder why they just left a bunch of artifacts laying around. There's lithium and tons of salt. That's odd. I don't really know what's in here. It doesn't really look like there's any real direction here because it just kind of goes everywhere. What is that? Is that gold again? Jeez, I just fill my inventory like nuts. Whoa. Ow. Die. Die. Where are you? Dead. Okay. Insert fuel crystal? Fuel crystal? Whoa! Okay, scan this. I can't scan it. So I gotta find a fuel crystal, it looks like. Okay, fuel crystal. That is my next thing to get. Why do I need a fuel crystal, and where does this go to? Is that just a glitch, or is that actually a hole in the wall? That's actually a hole in the wall, but I don't know what that is. Ooh, another artifact! Go away! Go away! Stupid thing. Lithium. I don't really need that. There's like butt tons of lithium everywhere you look around here. Which is awesome. I'm not seeing any fuel crystal, though. So I will have to find either a way to build one, or I will have to find one somewhere around here. And that is a huge Bulbo tree. But I'm not really seeing it. And although I've looked pretty much everywhere I can find, the issue I'm having is that this thing weaves in and out, and I was just here. Anywho, down we go into the depths and back to our new home base. And there's that guy. I'm tempted to see if I can kill it. Okay, they can noclip too. Never mind. But if I could kill one of those, that would be pretty nice because I'd like to see what they look like. Maybe I could actually scan it if it was dead. But that will be something I need to figure out in good time. So, until then, I'm going to go down here, get my new base, and first I have to find the entrance, which I think the entrance is right here. All right, cool. Nothing seems to have changed. That's good to know. All right, so the first thing I need to do is build a little storage area for temporal storage. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use, I guess just a compartment. All right, so we are back. And here, as you can see, I have built myself a mini base. Now, here's something odd here, though. I can't put above water plants in this plant, in the splinter box. I don't know why. It's probably because I'm below the ocean level, which gives me an idea that I want to check out later. But as you can see in here, I have not yet finished everything yet. I still have these lockers to do. And fabricators, modification station, everything else. People are talking like nuts. But anyways, I need to get me some food, and then I need to figure out how I am going to put plants in there. Okay, so water is back up to normal. Food's up a little bit. Now, where was I? Building this. Exterior grow bed. Okay, so now I gotta put the creep vine in there. Oh, it's seriously gonna grow in here. That is going to be interesting. I'm gonna put the... I think I'm going to put the blood root in here because that one grows low. And then I really want to see what this this purple brain coral is going to do. Does that mean the oxygen is just going to float to the ceiling, or how does that work? Anyways, I also need to do acidic mushrooms if it doesn't glitch out. And these. And apparently... Can I not grow those? Maybe I can cut it. Oh, fudge. Apparently I can. And that's how they get done. Wow, that really hurts you, doesn't it? Okay, acidic mushrooms are now being grown. So that's good. Next thing I need to do is figure out what to do with the above water stuff now. Because I put it all in, I believe, this locker. But I can't grow any of it now. Ooh, I could grow it in here, though. I have a lantern tree growing here. I don't know. The other thing that I really need to work on is powering this thing, because I haven't yet tested if solar panels work. And if it does, that would be pretty awesome, but it's inside the building, so it shouldn't theoretically work. I think I have one quartz in here, though, so that should work for me. Ooh, how many do I need for it, though? Solar panels are 2 quarts. 2 quarts? All right, let's roll. Hopefully this thing can be powered. What? How did that get out here? I don't even know how that happened. Okay. Make this. If this powers it. Oh, it totally works!
Power restored. Welcome primary systems online.
What?! That is just unfair and cheating, basically. But you know what? I'm not gonna complain about it. Now I should probably put all the rest of the stuff in there. And I also have this science type of thing that I gotta put in there. I don't research stuff, I guess. I don't know what that's for, if I can actually use it or not. It was in, not that one. This one. Lab equipment. That's what I was looking at. All right. Contracts, good. Radiation chute, mobile bay. And the lab equipment I've been wanting to put somewhere for a while. So there we go. I can't actually use that, can I? Dang it. I thought maybe I could use it. That would be really cool. Oh, I just realized something. The reason my Cyclops is floating all weird is because of these guys. Oh! Jeez, I could make anything float with that, couldn't I? Pretty much everything is away. I'll put some more stuff away later. But, as I have been waiting for quite a while, I want to find out what is in this room over here. And to do so, I must put in an artifact, which I have three of those on me, so hopefully I don't need to get all three of them. Boop. Calorie deficiency detected. Of course they want me to eat. But I think I can live a little bit longer without dying. What is this? Wait, what? Well, uh-oh. Whoa! Oh, what? I have an elevator! That is awesome. Ooh, what is that? Scanny. Data terminal. Unknown language. Attempting translation. Ooh, okay, so what do we get?
Unknown language, attempting translation.
Okay, I got that. Data download. Unknown, alien data. Alien schematic. This data set appears to be a multidimensional schematic of some kind. By mapping the pattern of three-dimensional space and its possible... space, it is possible to gather the basic understanding of the facility's internal workings, which may help identify a way to disable it. Once again, why am I disabling this? Facility's unknown constructivity material is identified as an ultra-hard, non-reactive metal amalgam? I don't know how to say that. Synthesized from off-world materials. There's no indication that it can be damaged or destroyed by no means. Powered by a separate self-sustained power plant located elsewhere on the planet. Okay, so that's where it's powered, so I could get one of those. Location is not listed, but there's evidence the designer intended the harness to harness the planet's natural thermal energy. Ooh, cool. Okay, alien structure. Oh, here's the outbreak. In the event of outbreak, quarantine procedures with automatic enforced with immediate effect. The quarantine enforcement platform will target all incoming and outgoing craft to prevent spread of infection off-world. The facility was built at 700 meters deep, approximately 1 kilometer south. Okay. That one guy was coming to pick me up, and I think the reason he hasn't shown up is because I haven't really looked to see if he's shown up yet. Ooh, scan. So it's best I don't answer any calls until I get this thing disabled. Patterns on the walls cannot be certain whether they are persons. Whoa. Stuck on things. What is that? Okay, so it lights up as you get close to it. That's kind of cool. I would like lights like that. Like, it gets brighter as you get close to it. Ooh, more stuff! Dibs! Okay. Alright. This is like the palace room. Ooh, more data. Well, I think I found myself the jackpot and stuff.
Unknown language. translation.
Good. Okay. It is likely the alien species which designed this technology evolved or genetically selected sensory apparatus to hear and understand. Whoa. They can communicate with devices?
Emergency. Starvation imminent. Seek calorie intake immediately.
Whoa, okay, so if they could communicate with my vehicle. That explains that one fish that could speak in Maria's voice. Which is kind of cool, but does that mean I get the power? Oh, that would be cool. I gotta go get food, and then I'm gonna go explore the rest of this place. I don't believe I've been this far. Okay, this is new, I believe. Oh! This is the doorway back out! Well, I don't really need to do that. That would just waste an artifact. And I believe there's more than one place I can use an artifact here. So I want to check out the rest of the area before I go unlocking every door, even though I can already get in. So, getting down here. Bloop. So I got to make sure that sunbeam doesn't show up. And I haven't answered any calls, so they shouldn't show up until after I try to disable this thing. Because I'm guessing they're going to get blown out of the air. And I prefer they don't die for no reason. So, we'll make sure not to contact them. Zoop! Down we go. The sun is setting. And I'm falling. In slow motion. Okay, that is just weird. Look at this. My theory is correct. I can just stand on top of this little brick. Bloop, bloop, bloop. That is so odd. Okay. And that looks like my stuff. It's not actually that high off the ground. I can get it from this level. I thought it would be a whole nother level up, but it appears that I don't have to worry about that. So, cool. So I'll just take those two and I'll replant them here because I always need these grapevine seeds for the lubricant and stuff like that. So, that being said and done, I believe... Is that everywhere? Ouch. Is that everywhere I can go up here? Oh, no it isn't. I got a place right here. Oh, I think I've explored this one because I scanned this earlier. I may have done that off camera though. I don't really remember. There wasn't anything else in here, so I don't believe I did put it in there. But if I didn't put that in the last episode, this was here too. So that was one other part. All right. Well, that appears to be everything I need here. Next episode, I do plan on going down and checking out the facility kind of south, west of here. Also, I'm going to get a repulsion cannon because I got to knock those things off. They're making my thing float, and I can't grab them for some reason because they're flipped backwards. So I'll figure that out by the next one. But I did get more ion crystals, which is great. I don't believe there's anything else I can do as far as the energy core. I'm looking to... Actually, it was an energy crystal. It was an energy crystal. And I got to figure out how to make that because if I can make that, that would be phenomenal. And I could unlock that thing outside on the other part of the island. So, until then, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to leave a double thumbs up down below if you like what you see. This episode, I got a lot done, but I didn't get as much on camera as I'd like to. Just because it was kind of a boring episode. But we will have more things later on, and I actually could put like a whole bunch of creep vines in this entire area. That would look really cool because they're above water now. Or... quote unquote above water. They're technically below sea level, and I believe that's what everything is related to. But I'm hungry. Nope. And this. Yum. One more. Alright, I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.